Hello, in this video I will show you how to create an SCL file with Straton. We will create an SCL file from scratch and see what we can do with the help of the SCL editor tool integrated to Straton. This tutorial is also available in Straton in the help tutorials tools IEC 61850 SCL editor. You can also find an example of an 850 server application installed with Straton editor. It is available in the demo project here, and it corresponds to the Energy 61850 application. The SCL file is here. We can recognize it from its logo, and it looks like that in the editor. The SCL file, the System Configuration Language file, is used to configure an IEC 61850 server. To make it very simple, it describes the functionalities the IED has. IED meaning an intelligent electronic device. All the details about the SCL file can be found in the IEC 61850-6 standard. As this is standard, this is independent from the manufacturer. So what we will create here can be read by any 61850 compliant SCL editor and used on any 850 server. So we will start from zero, from a new project. First, we close this project list. We click on File, Close Project List. And then we create a new project, clicking on File, Add New Project. We choose a destination folder. We choose a name. We click on Next and on Finish. The project has been created here in our project list in the top left. And here we are. We have two ways to create the SCL file. From the menu, Tools, SCL Editor, it opens the SCL Editor as standalone, or directly as an item in our project. To do that, we do a right click on the project, insert new item, others, and we can see IEC 61850 SCL Editor. We will use this solution as the file will be created directly in our project and it will be easier to recover it. We click on Next, we choose a name, and we click on OK. The file has been created here, and if we open it, it created an ICD file, meaning an IED capability description file. For the moment, it contains nothing and my device is called template. I can start to change this. Okay. And then it follows the same principle as the field buses configurations. It means that the file is configured using the buttons on the left, from the top to the bottom. For the moment, all buttons are grayed, and the only one which is available is Add Logical Device. So I will click on this button. And now I can choose between edition 1 or edition 2 of the standard. Depending on this choice, more or less things, logical nodes, data objects, will be available in the editor. I will choose edition 2, OK, and automatically it opens a pop-up window, allowing to declare logical nodes. It proposes by default logical node 0, which is mandatory. I can see here the type name, a small description, and some details. I can see the data objects for logical node 0. And if I double click on the command data classes, I can see the data attributes. Everything is configurable according to the standard. To keep it simple, I will keep it as it is. So I just click on OK. It asks me to declare the LPHD node, the Physical Device Information node, which is also mandatory. So I click also on OK. Now the file is ready. I will click on this button, Check Syntax, to check that everything is right according to the standard. It says that enumerated data types must be set with the default values, so I can double click on the warning message and see that here, for the logical node 0, data object behavior, and the data attribute estival, I have to set a default value. I click on default values on the default button, so it's easier. I do the same for the LPHD. Okay, I click on check syntax again, and I see that now the check succeeded. So now my file is really ready. I have always to think to save the file. For the moment, it has a star here indicating that it's not saved. So I click on the save button and the star disappears. The file is saved in the projects folder. So in order to open this folder, I click on the project. I press Ctrl-Alt-E and now it opens automatically a Windows Explorer and I can see the content of my projects folder. If I go down, I can recover my IED.icd, which I just created just before and just saved at the moment. I double click on the file if I want to open it and see what's inside, and I can recover everything I configured in the SCL editor. For example, my logical device called LDevice, with logical node 0, with the data objects and initial values and some data attributes. That's it for today. So in the next video, we will see how to use this SCL file. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and see you in the next one.